It's AumSum time!
Why do we dream?
So that we can eat without getting fat.
No. For centuries, experts are trying to find the actual purpose of dreams, but still no one has any concrete answer. One theory proposed by Sigmund Freud states that we dream to fulfill our wishes. Dreams are a representation of our unconscious desires, thoughts, etc. Each image in a dream has some meaning. As these thoughts are not expressed consciously, they find their way via dreams. Another theory called threat stimulation suggests that dreams should be seen as a defense mechanism. For example, nightmares put us in threatening situations, allowing us to practice our fight or flight response, which can be helpful in real-life events. A theory called activation synthesis suggests that dreams don't mean anything. During REM stage of sleep, certain circuits in the brain get activated. When the brain tries to synthesize and make sense of these signals, it results in dreams. Are you afraid of heights? Do you think it is because of vertigo? Vertigo is not necessarily fear of heights. In medical terms, vertigo refers to a false sensation of movement due to which we feel dizzy. The most common type of vertigo is benign paroxysmal positional vertigo, or BPPV. It is caused when our inner ear, which helps us maintain balance by detecting motion and position of our body, doesn't function properly. Normally, when we move our head, the cilia and calcium crystals in our inner ear move, thus sending signals to the brain about our movement. However, sometimes some crystals dislodge and move into the fluid-filled semicircular canals. Now, when we move our head, the crystals move along with the fluid. However, even after our head movement has stopped, the crystals keep moving in the canals, thus sending wrong signals to the brain that our head is still moving. Due to this wrong information, the person gets a false sensation of movement, which makes him feel dizzy, thus causing vertigo. Why are fish eating plastic? Every year, about 8 million metric tons of plastic waste is dumped into our oceans. Hence, in some parts of the oceans, there is more plastic than planktons and krills, which are a source of food for many fish. Now, according to a research, fish eat plastic because it breaks down into smaller fragments which are similar to the size of planktons. In addition to this, the plastic fragments present in salty seas or oceans release odor similar to that given off by planktons. Hence, fish mistakenly assume the plastic fragments to be planktons and thus eat them. As a result, many of them die. Besides this, some of these fish even reach our table as seafood. If we eat such fish, it can cause severe health problems. Hence, it is very important to recycle plastic and use eco-friendly products like paper bags. Why is it hard to cure cancer? Cancer is not a single disease. It is a name given to a collection of diseases that have some common characteristics. Cancer usually begins when there is a sudden change or mutation in the genes present in our cells. This leads to uncontrolled cell division. Now, it is hard to cure cancer because every cancer is caused by a different set of genetic mutations in different types of cells. Hence, it is a different disease each time, due to which a treatment which works for an individual doesn't necessarily work for the other. Now, cancer cells can be killed with treatments like chemotherapy or radiation. However, sometimes these treatments may not kill all the cancer cells, risking a cancer relapse. Moreover, such treatments even harm healthy cells of our body. Cancer cells can even metastasize. That is, they can spread to different body parts and start growing there, thus making it difficult to eradicate cancer completely. In addition to this, many cancers are diagnosed at very late stages, which makes treatment less likely to succeed, thus reducing the chances of survival.